captain and storyteller aboard Aurora. For your safety, please remember to keep your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the boat at all times. And please supervise your children so our story doesn't take any unexpected turns. For those who love to travel to enchant and world through pages of a book, most people like to travel in person. And for those who do, find their way there quite magical or even fantasy. Dun, dun, dun. But not to worry, folks, it looks like we're passing right through the jaws of Monstro the Whale. We're really being transported into a magical place called Storybook Land. Yay! Now, if you thought that was scary, coming up on our left-hand side is going to be the cave owned by the big, bad wolf, who's constantly trying to get to the three little pricks who luckily live across the way here in three little houses, with one being made of strong, the other being made of thick, and the other one being made of guaranteed wolf-proof bricks. Now our story's gonna take a strange turn and we're gonna come across the quaint English village, home to Alice, where she followed a white rabbit down the rabbit hole and fell down, down, down into Wonderland, where her life only got curiouser and curiouser from there. Now coming up here on our right is going to be London Park, where most of our residential ducks reside. It's also going to be the place where Peter Pan, John, and Wendy first took flight on their way to Neverland, with the help of Tinkerbell's pixie dust, of course, they were able to never ever have to grow old. And Agrabah, the city of mystery and enchantment, where a street rat named Aladdin bumped into Princess Jasmine at the marketplace and stole her heart. With the help of Genie, of course, they are now happily married and live here in Sultan's Palace. Going to pass through these arches where love blooms and blossoms. We're gonna soar over, sideways, and under on a magical boat ride into a whole new world. And here you'll see a human circus. We get a new inventory every 15 minutes. Now, not all fairy tales end with a happily ever after. Wonders just straight ahead, where treasure bears a curse. Legend has it, if you find a golden lamp, rub it three times, a magical genie will come out and grant you three wishes. Let's all go ahead and make some wishes. I wish for a churro. I also wish for us to get out of this cave as safe and sound as possible. Coming up on our right-hand side is going to be the cottage owned by the Seven Dwarves, where they found Snow White as she ran from the evil queen when she wished for some refuge. And in thanks for her kindness, the Seven Dwarves let her stay in the cottage. You can even see their mind and probably even listen whistle while they work. And here on our left, you can see the beautiful castle where Cinderella wished to attend the ball, but her evil stepmother and evil stepsisters forbade it. But luckily for her, her fairy godmother was able to grant her that wish and she attended the ball. But since Cinderella didn't come home by midnight, her carriage turned back into a pumpkin, which you can still see there on the bridge today. Luckily for her, love does prevail. Her and her Prince Charming are now happily married and live in the castle atop the hill. If you guys run into Cinderella, don't tell her, but I bought her a shoe rack for Christmas so she can stop losing all her slippers. Now here on our left, we're going to see a beautiful floral crystal-like landscape that was inspired by our 1933 Silly Symphony cartoon Lullaby Land. With stories that include a mole, a rat, and a toad. Of course, folks, I'm talking about Mr. Toad, which coming up on our left-hand side is going to be his daily manor where he resides. Let's go ahead and see if he's home, folks. Well, it doesn't look like he's home right now. He's probably off doing some last-minute Christmas shopping, but you can most likely find him in Fantasyland. But be careful, folks. He's known to be a crazy driver. And the magic never stops here in Arendelle as we pass by Elsa's beautiful ice castle when she ran on top of the fjord. Her sister Anna came to her rescue. And once Anna was able to bring her dear sister back into Arendelle, she was able to ask Aunt Elsa again, "Do you want to build a snowman?" Now here straight ahead is going to be the village home to Geppetto, where he wished for his puppet to become a robot. And once Pinocchio saved him from Belly the monster of the whale, the blue fairy was able to grant him that wish. And here on our left is our world famous sauna. Just like Geppetto's wish for his puppet to become a real boy, Princess Ariel's wish was to have her own set of legs. And once her wish was granted, she was able to ditch her life under the sea, walk across land, and find her true love, Prince Eric. And they are now happily married here on your right-hand side. And her story comes from the shadow of her father, King Trident, which he lived here in Atlantica on your left. And with every story, it is going to end with a happily ever after. And as we come approaching the dock, I would like to ask you guys to remain seated with your hands, arms, feet, and legs in such a bowl at all times. And on behalf of the storytellers here at Storybook Land, we all wish you guys a magical day here at the Disneyland Resort.
Alrighty folks, when my bow comes to a complete stop, I'm going to count to three, and once I do, we're all going to stand in the center of the boat so no one has to go under the sea. Alrighty folks, please remain seated for me. And remember everyone on my dock, keep your hands, arms, and fingers away from the area.